Hi, I'm back. Went thrifting again, a few things. I've got a few things I'm really excited about. I have a funny story about my first item. This bag is called it's like Roman numeral 3 parcel, PARCEL. And it's a really super cute bag. And I stopped at a little store. A little antique store. Well, it wasn't antique, a thrift store. And but they had their prices marked for collecting, not for thrifting. And so I there had some really cute stuff in there, but I wasn't gonna really purchase anything. But I always look at purses because I'm always looking for the foam cord purses. And so as I was looking around, I picked up this bag because I thought it was cute. And it's vintage looking and even Jamaican looking. So in that, I happened to peek in the pocket, and in the pocket was money. And so I'm like, okay, I'm not gonna just take the money out and walk away. And so I'm going to see how much the purse is. It was $3. So I went ahead and bought the purse and thinking, well, if they look through the pockets before they sell it to me, whatever money's in there, I didn't know how much it was. I just kind of saw it in there, and whatever money is in there, they can have it. But if not, no big deal. So I bought it, $3, got out to the car and pulled the money out with something else, and it was $3. So basically, I got the purse for free, and that was kind of fun, I guess. But then they also had Arlington Racetrack horse racing tickets in there, $2 each. There's several of them here from May 2009, so 10 years ago, it looks like, is when this purse was maybe last used. I don't know. So anyway, I also not from the from a different store. This looks like Salvation Army because I went to Goodwill, Salvation Army, and a couple other thrift. I don't really feel like I did really well for as many places as I went. It just kind of felt like an day. But with that being said, I did get a few pieces. So this one's a German cup, very, very pretty. And I can't read what's on it, but whatever that says is German. And the comps on it, there's something very similar to it. Selling $15, $20. I paid 97 cents for this. And then I got a border collie. Isn't that pretty? Really pretty from Brazil. This isn't selling for much, maybe $4 or $5. How much did I pay for this? They didn't have a price tag on it, so I think she said it was like $3.99. So I'm not gonna make a big profit on that, if at all. But that's okay. Found a Chicago another Chicago mug, frosted. This one's Goodwill for 99 cents. I haven't been able to find any comps on this. I have not seen another one like this. Now, I did find a frosted, I believe it was a Navy Pier, and with that one, they were asking like $15 for it. So I don't know if I'll list that one or keep it because I like the Chicago mugs. So then I found, look how pretty these are with the gold embossed etching on, or etching and the rim. And the green is blown into the clear crystal. I paid $2, $1.99 each, and I got four of them. I can't find any of these online yet, so I don't know. And then this, I think I'm gonna keep this. This is Studio Pottery, and it's a candle holder. But look how pretty this is. I paid $1.97 for this, and it's just such a fascinating piece that I'm probably gonna keep this. I just think this is such a neat piece. I got this lamp, and this lamp, you can tell the age of a lamp by its cord most of the time, unless it was already rewired. And I will rewire this because this is not up to code, cord. But you see that the prongs are all one. They're not the big one and the little one like the modern day ones are. So this is probably 50s. I don't know the make of this lamp. It's got felt on the bottom, and so there's no markings on the lamp telling me who made it. But Very, very pretty lamp. I just really liked this lamp. And I paid $4.96 for this. And it had a light bulb in it, but I told them to keep that. I didn't want to take the light bulb home with me. Now this piece, I got two pieces that are supposed to have stoppers in them as well. This one, isn't this pretty? $2.99 with the gold. It's gold. Now the other ones that I've seen online have little cups that go along with it and the stoppers. But they also come in green, and so on the gold and the green, and they're really, really pretty. But these are 50s decanters, and so very, very pretty. I was real pleased with that. And then I got another one that's supposed to have a stopper, and this is a coffee warmer, atomic style 50s, 60s atomic style coffee warmer with the Bakelite handle. And again, it's supposed to have a stopper on the inside, but this one doesn't. And I paid $5 for this, but it'll still sell. That's where the candle goes. In fact, there's still a candle in there, and I'll probably stick it in the freezer and work it out. And then we got these. From what I can tell, I think they're Tollware. I paid $2.97, and there are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11, and they're just little tiny trays. And there's one blue, and then there's two of these gold, and then there's the rest of them are these like two turtle doves or whatever. So, and but they're like individual serving trays. So they're gonna be kind of fun to, but I think they're Tollware. I'm not sure. From the only comps I can find online are Tollware, and this would be the blue one is the only one that resembles what Tollware looks like. The rest of them don't resemble Tollware at all. $2.99 in a little bag, some old wooden 70s style coasters. And I think these are really cool. So got the paisley style on it, which these colors and style was very popular in the 70s. And then this is, I found a salt and pepper shaker. Yes, is that cute? And you can see it's written in Pakistan, I think is what this is. Portuguese, not Pakistan, Portuguese. If I could get it to read. There we go. I had to do a Google Translate on it. And so this is Portuguese. These are Portuguese salt and pepper shakers, but aren't they adorable? And then I'm gonna move things around here. Trying to get that set back up without falling. It's not setting, there we go. And then I got six, and I didn't realize it until I got home that there are three in the corner and the patterns are different. Now, when these are similar to Dorothy Thorpe has the silver band, but these have etchings. And this design actually matches the plates that I got for my daughter-in-law and the teacups that I have listed on my eBay store right now. So there's three of these, and then there's three of the floral design, which are very, very pretty too. I don't know, you can see it, there you go. Now, I didn't realize it until I was at the checkout and the girl made it look like it was gonna be a real big hassle to reverse the sale on these. But it's okay, I can probably sell them anyway. So these are the perfect ones. And then somebody put tape, and you can see how it's all, the silver is gone. This is not in the glass, it's on the exterior of the glass, the silver. So if you put tape on anything like this, even if you put tape on something like this, peel the tape off, it's gonna come off. And that's what it looked like has happened on several of these, is somebody peeled the tape off, and you can see they put the sticker here. So what I'm gonna do is, I got all six of these for $6.99, $7. I'm gonna soak it in warm soapy water to get the sticker off. And that's how you handle, don't peel the tape off of anything. soak it in warm soapy water so that it doesn't peel any, like the same thing here, if they had put tape on that, it would have peeled it off. So you can't peel the tape off. They don't care, they're just marking it, putting it on the shelves, and letting it go. They don't care where they're putting the tape, they don't care where they're putting the price tags, they don't care. They just need to get it all out of these bins of thousands and thousands and thousands of things that have been donated to them. They're just getting it out, getting it on the shelf so that it can get sold. So they don't care. They don't care if it gets chipped, they don't care if it gets damaged, they don't care. They're just trying to get it processed. So that being said, don't ever peel the tape off of anything. Soak it in warm water, warm soapy water, and it will work its way off. It may not come off fast, it may take a while, but it will come off. Okay, rant over, off my soapbox. So I got 4 coffee mugs, and these are really cool, $1.97 each, and each one has a different design. And I looked them up online, and to be honest, I can't find, the only thing that I could find was a set of 3, so somebody was missing the 4th one, and they're small espressos. These are coffee mugs, and they're Tatiana for Mosca. And so they, they're rare, like they weren't made a lot. They didn't do a lot of these. And just the 3 espresso cups were going for, I think it was like $25. So for the 4 of these, I will probably list them for maybe $30 for all 4. I'm not looking at making a big profit. I just want to get these off the shelves and not go to a landfill. Let's see, I talked about my lamp. Did I talk about my lamp? I did talk about my lamp. Okay, I had to do this video over again because I ran out of storage space, so I had to go in and delete a bunch of stuff. So yes, I did talk about my lamp. Okay, also, Ray Dunn is very popular also. I paid $3.99 for this, and this is, it says spruce on it, and it is a Ray Dunn canister. So this particular canister sold on eBay for $20, 19 something. So that's not a bad thing. And then I got myself an orchid pot. This one I won't be selling, it's big. So I will be able to put, I've got a bunch of orchids. They're all in my bathroom and they're all still in the original container. So this one I paid $1.99 for, and I will be putting my orchids in that because I really like it. Now you guys, I'm going to show you, this thing is so cool. Ugh, don't fall. I'm going to show you this. Super cool. Look at this sewing box. I know, right? Okay. So now it is, one of the legs is missing on the bottom, and I didn't realize that because when you put it in the basket, you can't, it wobbles anyway. So yeah, one of the legs on the bottom is missing right there. It's all right. And then, but it opens up. Let me see if I can just hold it down so you can see. Okay, so it opens up like so, and it has like old bobbins in it, and then this slides out like this. It's got old scissors. This isn't old. This is a nice roller, so I'm gonna definitely keep that. It's got old scissors in it. It's got old buttons. Look at this bobbin. Look at that. It's just super old. And then I'm afraid to take it out, but these razor blades, you can't even get these razor blades anymore. And sewers, even when I sew, I used to use a lot of razor blades. But then there are a couple of things you can't really get anymore. And my mom had one of these. The tomato pin cushion. Isn't that cool? There's a bunch of old buttons. And then look at this pin cushion. Check that out. Isn't that so pretty? Open it up. I still got the old pins in there. Now, this one did have a measuring tape on the bottom, but and made in Japan, but that's been broken a long time ago. So anyway, yeah, so I don't know how much I'll list this for, because I'll list it with all of the thread and stuff in it. And then a couple more things I got to reach over here for. Pottery. I found some studio pottery again. And this studio pottery, I paid $2.99 for this. Oh, I think I paid $6.97 for the sewing box. Okay, so for this studio pottery, I paid $2.99 for. And it says T-S-S-C-H-U-D-Y. Anyway, so this is, doilies. They would press doilies into it after they painted it, press a doily into it. And so I thought it was really, really pretty. So I was excited about that. And then my freebie I found in the alley behind my house, look at that, retro shelf. Look at that. So it's like a plate shelf. I'm sure we all remember this from when we were young. Retro plate shelf. Anyway, I'm gonna have to let you go because I'm running out of space. So I will see you next time.